Dobrý den, přátelé.
Hello, dear friends. I'm happy I can welcome you again by watching a regular online series. He is coming soon.
Může přijít. Náš seriál je
Our series is about the rapture, and I'm happy to welcome Sergej Michal again, the author of the book He is Coming Soon. The book in Slovak original, but also released in Czech language and in English. I would like to turn to page 9. When I was studying at home, I made a notice that you mentioned four pillars of your book. Yes, indeed, I mentioned four pillars of the text in the scripture that are connected to each other and they support each other. The first one who emphasized the rapture from theologians was the Apostle Paul, who writes in Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 15, according to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together. This is very important. Those who are still alive are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. So Jesus will fulfill what he promised in the chapter 14 to his disciples, where he says that in my dad's house there is a lot of room and I will come back for you and I will take you to be with me where I am. And the promise that I will come back and take you with me is described in Luke chapter 17, verse 34. I tell you, on that night two people will be on one bed and one will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding together. One will be taken and the other left. Two will be in the field, one will be taken and the other left. And the whole meaning of the rapture was revealed in Luke 21, verse 34. And it hides a profound meaning. This text makes it clear for us that it's an evacuation of the church from the world. Let's listen. Be careful, or your heart will be weighed down with carousing, drunkenness, and the anxieties of life. And that day will close on you suddenly, like a trap. For it will come on all those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. So, to escape from the world, from everything that will come upon it, means to be evacuated. But the world will go on. The judgments, the cataclysm that will come upon the world, maybe two-thirds of the world will die. God wants to evacuate church to protect her. And this is the meaning of the rapture. And if we see the context of the scriptures, as Jesus said, I will come and pick you up. And then he says, you will be able to escape from the things that will come upon the world. That gives us a picture about what the rapture is about. It's to take us from the world before the judgment comes. I have just realized that in the book of Revelation, in the Bible, those judgments are described. It speaks about seven seals, seven trumpets, and seven containers of God's anger. But in the time of the seals and of the trumpets, it speaks about huge problems, about huge attacks, speaks about things called apocalypse, really tough things. But it's not mentioned here. This passage says that they will be working on a field, or they will be lying in the bed, they will be in the mill. So, if the war comes, will it be possible for people to be calm in the field? Does it mean, will it be the same like in Noah's time? Yes, this is exactly the evidence for the preaching or the teaching about the rapture. Because the people, the first people who came with this were the apostles, and that's mentioned in the book of Acts. And then in the Middle Age, nobody talked about it. Then the Reformation and the Luther came. And people were focused on the Word of God because they needed to understand that the Word of God is true. Nobody was actually teaching about rapture because it was not revealed to them. But today, the church experiences the tension of Christ's second coming. And the teaching that emphasizes the rapture was started by John Darby or William Carey. And what I really admire about these two men is that they were preaching the Word of God in the 19th century. And the people living at the same time called them the experts of the Word, and they were teaching just according to the Bible. They didn't put any fantasies in. They didn't have anywhere to take it from, just from the Bible. And the whole teaching is not based upon a dream that appeared to someone. It's based upon the Word of Jesus, and it resonates in our soul because it's God's truth. And it's also supported by logic why God did it. Because when God does true things, He also does logic things. We can see it in the world how God created life. Is there any illogical thing? No. Everything puts together, everything fits in. I think this is a good topic to talk about because DNA appears in the very last chapter of your book, He is Coming Soon, and it's described very interestingly. But I would like to thank you for these four pillars that you described to us and that actually support that Lord will come and that He will come for those who are His. Thank you, dear viewers, for watching us. I'm thankful that we can have such an information from Sergei, and we're looking forward to watching the next part of our regular online series, He is Coming Soon. I will just add to Yiri that those are not information from Sergei, but from the scripture, and we're thankful for that. Goodbye.